anointed me. Spirit of the Lord is on me. Set all the captives free. Spirit of the Lord is on me.
On me.
For he has anointed me.
He has anointed me.
Spirit of the Lord is on me.
On me.
Set all the captives free. To heal the broken.
Saints of God, good to have you listening in tonight. I'm your host, Brother Greg Dodson, in here tonight for Brother Eddie. Brother Eddie is out and about doing the work of the evangelist tonight, and he asked us if we would sit in for him, and we told him that we would enjoy doing that. So, praise God, we're just going to sit back tonight. We're going to listen to a little music, and I tell you what, we're just going to have a good time in the Lord, praise God. I tell you what, there's no better thing to do than to sit around and enter into the presence of God and just lift up the name of Jesus Christ. Right now, we're going to listen to a little music by Clint Brown.
I think I gather here tonight with people that want to lift up the name of Jesus. Does anybody feel like praising him? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, put your hands together.
Sunshine, I'm gonna praise His name. Sunshine.
Praise God. If I don't light you fire, honey, you wood's wet. That's all I can tell you. Praise God. Just find you an old-fashioned prayer closet somewhere and steal away and call down that fire of the Holy Ghost in your soul, and you'll have all that wet wood dried up. Praise God. It's good to see Brother Roy King in the chat room tonight and Pastor Chris Hash and his wife Lori on the program with us tonight. And good to see you, Sister Jackie McLean, in the room. And, hey, it's good to see Philip and Petey in here tonight. And praise God, we're going to send this one out to Philip and Petey right now.
They whipped him up the hill just for me. They whipped him up the hill just for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. They whipped him up the hill just for me. They nailed him to a cross just for me. They nailed him to a cross just for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. They whipped him up the hill just for me. They laid him in a tomb just for me. They just for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. They whipped him up the hill just for me. The angel rolled the stone away just for me. The angel rolled the stone away just for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. They whipped him up the hill just for me. He's coming back from heaven just for me. He's coming back from heaven just for me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. They whipped him up the hill just for me.
Between the pages of an old family Bible, I found dates of births, deaths, and no revivals. Then I came up on a page, it was written by a feeble hand. It said, this is my last request, and these are my funeral plans. Oh, when I die, let me die speaking love. Let it ring.
preacher, speak your name one more time. Then I'll have your angels carry me over to the other side.
Oh, yes. A city 1,500 miles long, coming down out of heaven, there's room for everyone. Oh, John tells of a city 1,500 miles long.
Come on, 1,500 miles, 1,500 miles.
Oh, John tells of a city 1,500 miles long.
Lord, have mercy. my Lord.
Come on, son.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Oh, let's praise him, church.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord, we bless your name, Lord.
Glory.
Let's give the Lord some praise this morning. But Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. I said Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Just call him up and tell him what you want. Come on, say it now. I said Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Oh, Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Just call him up and tell him what you want. Well, if you want the Holy Ghost, tell him what you want.
On the main line, tell him what you want.
Oh, I said.
Praise God. Are you thankful that we got a main line tonight? Glory to God. I'm glad there ain't no mediator between me and Jesus. But praise God, we got a main line. Glory to God, saints of God. When we need to get a hold of the Master, there's no go-between between him and us. But praise God, we can steal ourselves away. And we can fall down on our knees, or we can meet him in a field, or just wherever you want to meet Jesus. He's right there, and he's waiting on us. He's waiting to hear from us. And I thank God for that. You know, if we served Muhammad tonight, we wouldn't have that. If we served Buddha tonight, we wouldn't have that. But praise God, we serve a living God. We serve a risen Savior. And I'm proud for that tonight. Right now, we're going to go and we're going to hear a word of preaching from Brother Steve Warren.
You just think, are you glad the Lord has been your dwelling place? Some of y'all sit up in here tonight, if it hadn't been for the Lord, which is on your side, if you had not got a revelation of who Jesus really is, he's more than just a piece of Sunday school itinerary. He's more than just a song that's sung or a go through the motion activity on Sunday morning and Sunday night and Wednesday night, but he is God, and besides him there is none other. And every characteristic of him comes and lives and abides in your house. See, the Bible said that if we draw nigh to him, then he turns and draws nigh unto us. In him coming and drawing to us, it fulfills the scripture in our life and turns a light of knowledge on and gives us some knowledge of who we are in Christ Jesus. That's why the real blood-bought and born again and redeemed of the Lord don't cry, I surrender, when the battle rages. We run to the rock that's higher than we are. We get under the shadow of the Almighty where the protection of God is. Some of y'all understand this because you have been in valleys of shadow of death. The pastor just told you that he spent 50-some days, didn't even know he was in the world. Somebody might say, well, how did he make it? How did he get from there to here? It's because he hid himself under the shadow of the Almighty. The Bible says that God holds you in the palm of his hand, and nothing shall be able to pluck you out. Aren't you glad that your God is different from Buddha and Mohammed and what they call Allah as a figure speech of a God? Aren't you glad that your God reigns forever? It says you have been my dwelling place in all generations. That means not only is he a dwelling place for me, he was a dwelling place for mama and daddy. And he'll be a dwelling place for the future. Psalm 91 verse 1. So he that dwelleth in the secret place or the dwelling place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And the writer says, and I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge. How many say mine too, preacher? Hallelujah. He's my fortress. He's my God. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Tell somebody, say, his truth, the truth that shall set you free. Jesus stood over Jerusalem one day and he cried out. He said, Jerusalem, how I long to tuck you under my wing like a mother hen with her chicks, but you would not hear my cry. America needs to understand there's one God, there's one faith, there's one baptism, one God above us all, and one God residing in us all. There's only one God that hung on an old rugged cross and gave his life's blood, went into a tomb, and came out victoriously over death, hell, and the grave. There's only one great physician. There's only one mighty God and one Prince of Peace. Somebody shout, thank God for that dwelling place. Thank God for that dwelling place. I love that old song that says, I can't even walk without him holding my hand. God, I've got to preach. Thou art my joy. Thou, oh God, can I preach? When God spoke to Moses and told him to tell Pharaoh, I am that I am, said, let the people go. There was profound words spoke that day. People need to get a hold of that in this hour. Jesus was in essence of telling Moses, if you're sick, I am your doctor. If you're lost, I am your savior. If you need strength, I am your strength. If you need a hiding place, I am. revealed this unto thee. Even Jesus once again, he stared Peter away from the natural. This ain't a natural salvation. This ain't a natural victory. You can't get this at Walmart on the shelf. They don't have a buy one, get one free at Kroger. God, somebody help me. Somebody turn around and say, this ain't something you just go get and buy and purchase. This is something supernatural. Flesh and blood have not revealed this unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say that you're Peter. Thank God Peter knew him, that he knew Peter. Somebody say, he knows my name. Every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry, he knows my name. That's enough to make you shout your J.C. Penney heels off. Come on, somebody. He knows my name. I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer, he lives. Let all of heaven testify that this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer. So upon this rock, building the church, the stone the builder rejected, the stone that came tearing down out of Babylon that tore down the kingdoms of this world. I heard about a stone that came tearing down out of Babylon. Jesus is that stone that come tearing down out of Babylon. Jesus was the fire that spoke from the bush for Moses. Jesus is the ladder, like Jacob's ladder hung from the heaven. Somebody shout, he's my ladder from earth to glory. Dear God, do you understand? Jesus is my shepherd. He's got me covered. I spent about 7 or 8 years selling insurance. So help me, I walked up to the door one day in suit of clothes. Was just before I met my wife. Walked up to the door and I picked on the door, and this lady on the door, and she said, Elvis or Conway? I said, neither one. I'm an insurance salesman. She said, insurance salesman ain't supposed to have hair like that. I said, darling, I'm just glad to have some hair because my daddy was a bald man. That's what I told her. I said, my daddy took his tooth off every night and put it in a box. Got up in the morning, put tape up in it, and slammed it back down on his head. Spent 7 or 8 years selling insurance, trying to convince people that if you take this policy, it'll cover you. And I have spent 33 and a half years giving assurance away. Tonight I give you assurance. I check the tomb. He ain't in there no more. Oh, dear God, he ain't hanging on a cross either. He's not a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes laying in a manger, but he's
Amen. Praise God for that. I want to say hello to Sister Rachel Honeycutt. See, she come in the room, and I can't remember if I said hello to Brother Grizzle or not, but Brother Grizzle from the House of Prayer, it's good to have you listening in tonight. And right now, I tell you, we're going to go and we're going to listen to a song by Sister Linda Johnson. I'm one of them. And praise God, I want to send this out to Pastor Chris Hash because I know he's one of them too.
By the way I talk, you can tell by the way that I wear my arms.
Well, praise God, Brother Chris. I know you're one of them. Praise God, I'm one of them, too. You know, when I heard that song the first time, it took me back in my mind to some of them services that we used to have down there at the Dole Church of God. Praise God, with Sister Brenda Ray and the Looper family down there, and praise God, just how the power of God come down and sat down in that church. Praise God. I tell you what, I'm thankful for those times. Thankful for those meetings we were in, but praise God, you know, the same God that was God back there in them meetings, He's the same God today. And you know something other? I believe we're fixing to move into a greater move of the Spirit than any of us has ever known. I tell you what, saints, if you think that Jesus is coming back for a bride of Christ that's barely held together and limping in, I hate to be the bearer of bad news for you. But praise God, I tell you what, He's coming back for a bride of Christ triumphant. Praise God, we've just barely scratched the realm in the surf, in the spirit realm. I praise God of what God's going to do in this last days that we're living in. And I tell you what, I look forward. And one of the things that we learned back in them days, me and Brother Chris, praise God, when we was first getting started off and everything, one of them things that God instilled in us back then, as long as we got King Jesus, praise God, we was going to be all right.
Jesus, I got it. here's one I think you'll recognize. If you do, I want you to sing along with us, all right? Still a good song. Still love singing it.
Yeah.
Praise God. I tell you what, I'm thankful for His amazing grace. And I hope you guys are enjoying the program tonight. I just didn't feel like doing a whole lot of talking or anything, but I don't know, just kind of felt led to play some music tonight. I just enjoying the music and everything. And this next song that I'm fixing to play, you know, I lost my mom back in 2012, and it was that was a real dark time for me. And I come across this song right here, and I tell you what, it brought a lot of healing to my heart. And this song is by the Tony Dean family. And if you'd never had a chance to come across their ministry, I encourage you to look them up and everything. You can find their some of their music on Amazon. You can also find the group Dean Family on Facebook and everything. They're out of Evarts, Kentucky. And I tell you what, this song really, really brought a lot of healing. So I hope you enjoy it. Be blessed.
A man lay on his deathbed, fighting for his life. The doctor said, "I'm sorry," as we gathered by his side. So I took him by the hand to say my last goodbyes, when a frail and feeble voice spoke up and gave me this reply and said, "You can't tell me I'm dying when heaven's gates swing open wide and Jesus there to welcome me. To the other side on the cross, deserving what they get. But one said, "Lord, remember me." It was his last request. The drunkard and the addict, we seem to forget. Christ died just the same if you're standing by their bed. So just remember Jesus loves them and He died for their sin. And don't be one to cast a stone, He'll judge in the end. You can't. Jesus died. it to the promised land.
You glad that there'll be angels in the room? Praise God. Well, right now, looking at the clock, it's getting probably about close to the time that my daughter is going to be getting ready to go to bed. Usually around 9 o'clock is her bedtime, so I got a feeling she's probably up there on the couch on her tablet listening to Daddy tonight. And so I just want to tell her good night and tell her Daddy loves you. And right now, we're going to go and get one of her favorite songs by Bishop Steve Warren.
Horses Jesus by our side. Gabriel, go blow your trumpet, and son, go get your bride. The sky will then be open, all the saints will rise on high. Then we'll ride those horses with Jesus by our side. Great white horses coming through the sky. Down will come the new Jerusalem. Old Satan will be stripped of his pride. We'll walk down the streets of that city, oh, in a robe of pure white. We'll know the splendor of heaven with Jesus by our side.
Good night, Madeline. Daddy loves you. All right, now we're going to go out, and I'm going to have a little fun right now. If Pastor Chris is still in the room, I'm going to send this song out to him, because this song not only applies to me, but praise God, it applies to him too. I love you, Brother Chris. You can brain me later.
Now, kids, be still. Brother Warren's getting ready to say the prayer over our Sunday dinner.
Thank you so much, Sister Nancy, and we'd like to bow our head right now. Dear Lord in heaven, we want to ask your blessings over all the chicken farmers across America and around the world. Lord, please let them have the best year ever. And Lord, we ask the blessings over KFC and over Bojangles and over Popeyes. And Lord, please bless Chick-fil-A. And now, Lord, we ask that you bless this here chicken right down to the last finger licking piece. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
When I was young, it seemed to me that preacher was 10 feet tall. Well, he'd shake the lights, knock the dust right off of that church house wall. He'd roam, snort, stomp his feet. Man, that preacher could preach. But Goliath couldn't hold a candle to the way that man could eat. That chicken-eating preacher man, his wife and 5 kids, used to come for Sunday dinner back when I was a kid. They'd sit there eating fried chicken, licking their fingers to the bone. I knew that preacher wasn't leaving till long the chicken was gone. Now, Mama used to tell me, son, you better mind your P's and Q's. And don't take but one piece of chicken, boy, till that preacher man gets through. I knew right then how old Blue felt, sitting waiting on a bone. And I'd say, why in the devil won't that preacher man go home? Lord, you delivered Jonah from the belly of that whale. And the story of old Daniel and those lions we all know so well. You saved the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace heat. But how you gonna save a little red rooster when the preacher gets ready to eat? That chicken-eating preacher man, his wife and five kids, used to come for Sunday dinner back when I was a kid. They'd sit there eating fried chicken, licking their fingers to the bone. I knew that preacher wasn't leaving till long the chicken was gone. To go on home, cause there was nothing left of poor little Red but only his bones. And me and old Blue, we sat there wondering, well, who would make the first move? Then the preacher laid his hands on them and said, my dog needs feeding too. That chicken-eating preacher man, his wife and five kids, it used to come for Sunday dinner back when I was a kid. They'd sit there eating fried chicken, licking their fingers to the bone. I knew that preacher wasn't leaving till long the chicken was gone. I knew that preacher wasn't leaving till long the chicken was gone. Yeah. Where's all that dessert you've been talking about? Talking about that nanner pudding. Chocolate fudge, marble cake, apple pies, coconut cream. My goodness gracious alive. Ha. Glory to God. My pickup truck. I was on my way to that patch in the woods before the sun came up. Lord, it's good to be living in such a great land where you can love God, family, and country and be a hunting man. Well, I'm a hunting man. The night and hill show. I'm riding home on a fishing bank or up in a deer stand. And just like old Phil Robertson, well, I'm a hunting man. You can call me a redneck, but now let me tell you some. But there's a lot more to this hunting thing than deers, ducks, and guns. Cause every man and woman who hunts understands. When you're in God's mother nature, you're close to the promised land. Well, I'm a hunting man and I don't care who knows that I watched a dynasty and the night at hell show. I'm riding home on a fishing bank or up in a deer stand. And just like old Phil Robertson, well, I'm a hunting man.
Hey, old Red, I thought I seen David Hale over there. Hey, David, what are you doing out here in these neck of the woods?
Well, Harold and I, Steve, were trying out a new turkey car. Is your wife Molly still mad at you for doing all that hunting?
Let me put it this way. I was in the doghouse, but even my old dog Red just threw me out. Sometimes it ain't easy being a hunting man. You know, I wonder if old Phil Robertson started out this way.
Well, I said, friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. He's my life when I need it to live. He's everything to me in this life that life can give. He's my living water when I needed that drink. He's the first thought in my mind each time I try to think. I said, friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. My joy, oh, that I love to feel. He's everything in this life to me that's really real. He is love, the only real love I've known. He can wash you in his precious blood, make you white as snow. Well, I said, friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. It is everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. He said I loved you, so he died. He told us he'd come back in time. And as the years go slowly by, that still preys upon my mind. I keep his picture on the wall of how he hung there on that cross. Yet he still loved us through it all, knowing he'll come back again. I got my Bible by the bed,
dated 1982. And his word written in red, and every single I love you, I'll go and see him just any day. Oh, and I'll never shed one tear. I'm all packed up to go away. I'll shout his praises loud and clear. He stopped death, hell, and the grave. He rolled the stone back from the tomb. And soon he'll carry his bride away. He stopped death, hell, and the grave. Mary came to see him just one last time. Oh, we all wonder if she would. And church, it keeps running through my mind. Oh, this time he's defeated hell for good. He stopped death, hell, and the grave. He rolled the stone back from the tomb. And soon he'll carry his bride away. He stopped death, hell, and the grave.
Praise God, I'm glad he stopped death, hell, and the grave for me. And praise God, I'm glad he did it for you too. Right now, we're going to go and play a song that's very near and dear to my heart. I tell you, the Lord blessed me with a good praying mama. And if it wouldn't have been for the prayers of my mom, I wouldn't even be here right now. And so I want to send this song out right now to all the moms.
Well, I've been to church on Sunday. You see, and I've been in jail. And I've put my family through more than I can tell. I've been a heavy cross to bear. On the wings of Mama's prayers, well, I spent her last dollar on something bad for me. Then I finally hit rock bottom. Oh, I couldn't get up on my knees, but I found the strength and it raised me up from there. On the wings of Mama's prayers.
Well, I seen her by the bed with her Bible open wide, looking up to heaven with tears in her eyes. She knew when I was in trouble. She knew when I was scared. I found salvation on the wings of Mama's prayers. Well, I was lost in the darkness, and I could not find the end. The light of my mama's love, you see, it pulled me back again. Oh, today I've got a place up in heaven. I'm going there on the wings of mama's prayers. Yes, I've seen her by the bed with her Bible open wide, looking up to heaven with tears in her eyes. Salvation on the wings of Martha's prayers. You see, today I'm still holding on to the wings of Mama's prayers. His head, compassion flowed in a scarlet stream when the soldier pierced his side. Every stain of sin was washed all away in that precious crimson tide. His love ran down the cross that day, and everywhere it fell, redemption reached out just in the soul from hell. Satan's plans for man were shattered right there at the foot of that old tree. He knew all was lost when Jesus paid the cost, and his love. They loved him, but because of God's command, you know, they had to watch the King of Glory be crucified by man. Even God, oh God the Father, oh, he could not look upon his plan as the love ran down the cross from Calvary's perfect lamb. His love ran down the cross. Redemption
lost when Jesus paid the cost and his love ran down the cross. His love ran down the cross. Suppose God searched through heaven and could not find one willing to be the supreme sacrifice that was needed to buy eternal life for you and me. Had it not been for a place called Mount Calvary, and had it not been for the old rugged cross. Called Jesus, then forever my soul would be lost. Well, I'm so glad he was willing to drink that bitter cup. He prayed, "Father, let it pass from me." But I'm so glad he didn't call heaven's angels that from my hands pull the nails that torment me. Called Mount Calvary, and had it not been for the old rugged cross, had it not been for a man called Jesus, then forever my soul. My soul would be
like yesterday. Though he was weak and he could not speak, he turned his head words I'd heard him say in life a thousand times. We've got a whole lot of reasons to go to heaven. We have so many loved ones waiting there. And if I had to face the fact we'd never meet again, that would be a lot for me to bear. There's a whole lot of reasons to go there. Almost everyone I know has a loved one who's crossed the tide. And if the Savior tarries, we all must cross that river deep and wide. But I made my with my mom and dad. But after that reunion, there is one who's greater still, 'cause he made the whole thing possible when he walked up Calvary's hill. We've got a whole lot of reasons to go to heaven. We have so many loved ones waiting there. And if I had to face the fact we never meet again, that would be a lot for me to bear. There's a whole lot of reasons to go there. I wanna go there.
Heavenly Father, we come before you right now. Father God, we thank you that your mercy and your grace endures forever. Jesus, we come to you right now and we thank you for the stripes that you took for our healing. And Jesus, we lift up Brother PD to you right now, Father God. And God, we ask that you administer healing right now, Father God, to wherever this wasp has bit him. And Jesus, we ask right now, Father God, that you would send ministering angels to wherever he's at. And Jesus, that you would remove the pain, for he's a child of God and he doesn't have to put up with this because you took the stripes for his healing. And Lord, we call it done right now and we thank you, Jesus. I thank you that you're our right now God. I thank you that we can serve you with now faith. And we thank you that you're a God that there's no distance in prayer. And so Jesus, we call this done right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you for administering healing to Brother Petey in Jesus' name.
Strength when I am weak. darkness, and it shines for all the world to see. It will shine on your heart if you will. When it finally shines on me. There is hope in that light form. The hopeless, there's a soothing balm there for pain and misery. As near as your face, but sometimes faith's a little hard to come by. I was so blind when it finally shined on me. There's a light at the end of the darkness. So look up when you are down and try to believe. Sometimes we have to be knocked down to make us look upward. I was looking up through the bottom when it finally shined on me, on me. I was looking up through the bottom. I was looking up through the bottom. I was looking up through the bottom when it finally shined on me.
Praise God, are you thankful for that light tonight? I tell you what, no matter how dark of a place you may think you're in, that light can shine down into that darkness. Praise God, you've not done nothing so bad. You've not done nothing so wrong that that light can't come into the darkest place and find you. And I praise God for that tonight. You know, I was down on the bottom when that light shined down on me. And I thank God for that light tonight. Right now, we're going to go into the vault. One thing that I like to do, I'm a person that's real big on our heritage. You know, God has left us with a great heritage. And I tell you what, I honor all the generals in the gospel that have went on before me. And praise God, you know, we need to be doing that, saints. We need to be honoring the men and women of God that have paved the way for us to do what we're doing now. And one of those generals of the gospel that's very important to my life is Bishop G.E. Patterson. So right now we're going to go into the vault and get one from Brother Patterson. So I hope this is a blessing to you.
My God, if you know him, if you know him, demons in hell can't turn you around. If you know him, can't nobody convert you with all of these other so-called religions and isms. If you know him. Glory to God. Wherefore, God has highly exalted him, given him a name that is above every name.
that at the name of Jesus. He didn't tell me it would happen at the name of Buddha, but at the name of I'm godly proud of my own family name. Proud of the accomplishments and everything that was done by my uncle, the late Bishop J.O. Patterson. Proud of the trail that was blazed as far as ministry is concerned with my father, Bishop W.A. Patterson, my uncle, the late Bishop J.O. Patterson. Proud of all that goes along with being a Patterson. But I'll tell you that it was not the name Patterson. That saved me. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. But it says that the name of Jesus. Every knee should bow. Every tongue, oh my God, shall confess. Look at the way it says it here. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven. Can anybody tell me what things are in heaven? I believe there are angels in heaven. And then it says of things in the earth. That word things is actually translated those. Not everything in heaven, but those in heaven. And I think you can understand that those in heaven are angels. Those in the earth are men. And then those under the earth are demons. He tells me that there are three realms. That when you call that name, that kneeling goes on. When you call that name in heaven, angels veil their faces. When you call that name on earth, men begin to rejoice. When you call that name down in the depths of hell, demons begin to tremble. Because there's no other name under the heavens given among men whereby we must be saved. And I hear Paul say that as I call that name, every knee shall bow of things in heaven, things in earth, things under the earth. But not only that, every tongue shall confess. What will they confess? Right now, it may be the Islamic Imam saying Assalamu Alaikum. But when Jesus comes, he's going to say Jesus is Lord. It may be the Indian witch doctor. But when Jesus comes, it's going to say Jesus is Lord. I don't care where it comes from. I don't care what he's saying today. But when Jesus comes, he's going to cry out, Jesus is Lord. He's Lord over my spirit. Lord over my soul. He's so much Lord until he could take a worthless sinner and wash him in the blood. And I come out sparkling as a saint sanctified by the blood of Jesus. He's so much Lord until he can take every sickness and every disease and give me an injection of the penetrating healing medicine of his own precious blood. And I walked out healed by the power of God. Whoa, he's so much Lord until he's Lord over all of my bills.
I may not be able to pay it, but I hear David say, trust him like I did. I've been young, but now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Lord, I wish you'd tell somebody I know Jesus is Lord. Hey, hey. Woo. Thank you, Lord. He is Lord. Though I say to that Mr. One Man Evangelist Party that's trying to convert folks to Islam or whatever he's trying to convert them to, I'm sorry, you can't fix me with that, because I'm already fixed. My heart is fixed, my mind is made up, I'm going with Jesus all the way. It makes no difference say, oh, I'm going with Jesus. Woo! Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you really save the day, you're safe. As I told earlier, because of Jesus, I hope that the church has a positive influence in your life. I hope that what we're teaching is enabling you to live a closer and more consecrated life in the sight of the Lord. But if you are really saved, you have to go back with the hymnologist and say, what a wonderful change in my life has been wrought since Jesus came into my heart. I've got joy in my soul for which long I've sought since Jesus came into my heart. I was on my way to a devil's hell. I wasn't fit to live. I was scared to die. Lord Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus came into my life. Come on. I gotta let it go. I know I've already worked too hard. It's 7:45 and now. But I can't help it. Every once in a while I feel like Ezekiel. I try to stop, but it's like a wheel. Turn over in my soul. Once in a while. It's like fire set up in my bones. Oh, I can't keep it to myself. I got to tell it to somebody else. Oh! Woo! Glory!
He had lain there so long, body racked with pain. Friends gathered round him, praying for a change. He said, I hear not the man a preaching in a little house downtown. If you carry back me, boys, I believe I'll go down. They have to tear off the roof, break down the wall, send up the praise, and the Holy Ghost did fall. They step into the water. Took her money.
Well, I got my hand on the gospel plow. Wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Just keep your hand on the plow. Hold on. Just watch that sun, see how she runs. Don't let it catch you with your work undone. Keep your hand on the plow. Hold on.
You see, the wise thing that I ever done 120 and all, they were waiting for the promise of the Holy Ghost to fall. Then suddenly a sound from heaven, a mighty rushing wind, filled the house where they were sitting as the Spirit moved on them.
This is that prophet Joel prophesied about. It'll make you laugh, make you cry, and even want to shout. All you need to do is get under the spout where the former and latter rain is being poured out.
Well, you may not understand and think it's mighty strange. He's still the same God today, and he won't ever change. Still saving souls, changing lives, if we so desire. So my friend, let him fill you with that Pentecostal fire.
This is that prophet Joel prophesied about. It'll make you laugh, make you cry, and even want to shout. All you need to do is get under the spout where the former and latter rain is being poured out. This is that prophet Joel
prophesied about. It'll make you laugh, make you cry, and even want to shout. All you need to do is get under the spout where the former and latter rain is being poured out. Where the former and latter rain is being poured out. I got a smile on my face, a little dance in my step. Folks think I want some money, but they ain't got it yet. All around the local town, they're starting to inquire. I got fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Hey, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that tent revival came up from Abilene. People's hearts are changing, even their desire. Getting fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Some folks got so excited, they ran all the way back home. When the whole place started shaking, need the power of the Lord. Miracles and wonders lasted for hours. They got fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Yeah, see, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that tent revival came up from Abilene. Hearts are changing, even their desire. Getting fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost in town, till the Holy Spirit hit him and he landed on the ground. Well, he took off to the local bank, bought robes for all the choir. He got fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Hey, 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 you see, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that tent revival came up from Abilene. People's hearts are changing, even their desire, and fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Hey, you see, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that tent revival came up from Abilene. People's hearts are changing, even their desire, and fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power.
Children, like old Job, who was put to the test. How he endured affliction gave to us a good description on how to trust the Lord and be blessed. There's gonna be a hallelujah meeting over yonder when we hear
hear the trump of God as it thunders. There's gonna be shouting, gonna be singing, like little David, gonna be dancing at that hallelujah meeting over yonder. Everybody says they want to go to heaven, but no one says they ever want to die. In your heart, keep things right. Live by faith and not by sight. And I'll see you at that meeting in the sky. There's gonna be a hallelujah meeting over yonder when we hear the trump of God as it thunders. There's gonna be shouting, gonna be singing, like little David, gonna be dancing at that hallelujah meeting over yonder. There's gonna be a hallelujah meeting over yonder when we hear the trump of God as it thunders. There's gonna be shouting, gonna be singing, like little David, gonna be dancing at that hallelujah meeting yonder, at that hallelujah meeting over yonder.
Jesus Christ. Oh, tell me, who's this man they say that the winds and waves obey? He's the Christ of Calvary, died on a cross for you and me. All of my life to him's been given, all of my sins have been forgiven. He's the only hope for living. Come see a man named Jesus Christ. Oh, come see a man.
Come see a man.
A man named Jesus.
Come see a man,
both the Lord and Christ.
The Lord and Christ.
Well, he turns water into wine.
He gives a sight back to the blind. He's the water and the bread. He's got the power to raise the dead.
Come see a man,
come see a man
named Jesus Christ. With his disciples on that day, who am I, do all men say? Some say John or the prophets of old, but Simon Peter had to stand up bold. Thou art Christ, the Son of God, all power in heaven and earth abroad.
He's coming back in glory divine, riding on a cloud and his face will shine.
Come see a man named Jesus Christ. Oh, come see a man.
Come see a man.
A man named Jesus.
A man named Jesus.
Come see a man.
Come see a man.
Both the Lord and Christ.
Both the Lord and Christ.
Cause he turns
water into wine. He gives a sight back to the blind. He's the water and the bread. He's got the power to raise the dead.
Come see a man.
Come see a man.
Named Jesus Christ. Well, he turns
water into wine. He gives a sight back to the blind. He's the water and the bread. He's got the power to raise the dead.
Come see a man.
Come see a man
named Jesus Christ.
Well, friends, I have enjoyed myself this evening. We are quickly, our time together is coming to a close, and I just want to thank you for taking time to spend a little time with me this afternoon. We hope that something another we have said or that we have played has been a blessing to you, and we want to thank Brother Eddie and Sister Pauline for yielding their pulpit to us tonight. When somebody entrusts you with their pulpit, that's a great, great honor. And we love Brother and Sister Cheney to death, and we just thank the world, and we want to take time and tell them thank you. I hope to that each and every one of you makes it into a house of worship tomorrow. If you're in the Baxter or Cookeville area and you don't have a home church, I'd like to invite you to come down with ours and hear Brother Steve Warren, our pastor, and we would be honored if you would visit us. We're right now we're currently located in the Crossroads Middle School down in Baxter, Tennessee, and it would be a great honor if you would come and fellowship and come and be with us. Starting next Monday, we're going to be right here on Spreaker on our own radio show. And you can, if you haven't took time to connect with us yet, you can connect with us on Facebook at Consumed by Fire Ministries, the same name that you see me on here in the chat room. And you can follow us here on Spreaker under that same name. And we're going to be starting a new program next Monday called Camp Meeting Radio. And we're going to be doing a little bit of what we've done tonight. Plus, at, from time to time, we'll have different guests coming in and playing live music and sharing the word. And we're going to have different ministries from out of state. So there's going to be a lot of good things happening. And we just it's our hope and our desire that you would come over there and fellowship with us over there. And that'll be on every Monday through Friday, and starting at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, going to 8 o'clock in the afternoon. And so you guys just come over there and be a part of that, and we'll have a good time over there just like we've had tonight. Praise God. So right now we're going to play a few more songs with the time that we have left and play ourselves off the air. And I want to thank each and every one of you that come in tonight. And I want to tell you that we love you, we're praying for you, and we're expecting God to do great things in our lives and in your lives tomorrow morning as we enter into his courts with thanksgiving. And so y'all have a good night, be blessed, and we're going to play a couple more songs here, and we love y'all, and you guys have a good night and be blessed.
Here we are to praise. We are the people. Everything I got was born in prayer, travailing on my knees. Say what you want, say what you will, emotion's all we got. But when I feel the fire of the Holy Ghost, brother, that fire gets hot. And I believe, yes, I believe, I believe in true blood-bought salvation, living right sanctification with a Holy Ghost manifestation. I believe, yes, I believe.
Thank you. got to tell somebody. Tell somebody what he's done. I want to help somebody. Help somebody overcome. I need to let everybody see the power of his love. He said, speak to that mountain, and you just watch it be removed. There's no reason to doubt it. He'll do just what he said he'd do. 'Cause I know what he's done for me. No telling what he'll do for you. Jesus is the answer. He's the only one for me. I said my Jesus knows the answer, the solution for the need. Oh, my Lord can work miracles if we just choose to believe. Just trust in my Father. I know he's watching over me. Yes, he is. Oh, now Jesus is the answer. He's the only one for me. I said my Jesus knows the answer, the solution for the need. Oh, my Lord can work miracles if we just choose to believe. I said my Lord can work miracles if we just choose.